Surah Al-Kahf, the 18th chapter in the Quran, which is recommended to be read every Friday. And if you do so, a light will shine brightly from you till the next Friday. And if you memorize the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, you will be protected from the trials of Dajjal. This surah includes 4 historical stories from which we can derive amazing lessons from. So let's do it. This story is about number of young men who were driven out of their houses because they believed in Allah. They ended up in a cave where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them sleep for many years. That is 309 lunar years, which is 300 solar years. When they woke up, they felt they slept for a day or half of the day. So one of them went to the town, disguising himself, thinking that people would recognize him and harm him. Then he found out he was amongst the different people. The people of the town were amazed to see this person's appearance and the old coins he was using. This story shows that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects the righteous who believe in him, no matter how hard his situation is. The story about a man who owned 2 beautiful gardens, but he became arrogant and he had wealth. So he told his companion, "I am greater to you in wealth and in manpower." The man forgot to be thankful for the bounties Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed his gardens. This story is a lesson to those who take worldly matters for granted and they forget that whatever they have is a blessing from Allah, and Allah is capable of taking it all back if He wills. Once Musa alayhi salam stood up and addressed the people of Bani Israel. He was asked, "Who is the most learned person amongst the people?" Musa alayhi salam replied, "I." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reprimanded him as he did not attribute absolute knowledge to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa alayhi salam, "At the junction of 2 seas, there is a slave of mine who is more learned than you." Musa alayhi salam said, "Oh my Lord, how can I meet him?" So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed Musa alayhi salam on where to find the man who was known as Al-Khidr, the green one. Musa alayhi salam goes on a journey with Al-Khidr, where he learns that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows his knowledge only on whom he wishes. In this story, we learn that nobody should ever feel that he or she is most knowledgeable, as all the knowledge belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Al-Khidr says, "I did not do it of my own accord." Dhulqarnain, a righteous and a just king who traveled the land from west to east. The Quran mentions 3 of his journey. On his last journey, he reaches a place between 2 mountains where he met the people of a tribe. They asked him to build a wall between them and the people of Yajuj and Majuj, who were causing mischief in the lands. Dhulqarnain agreed to do so. Dhulqarnain was not proud of his achievement. In fact, the Quran says what Dhulqarnain said after building the wall. He said, "This is the mercy from my Lord. But when the promise of my Lord comes to pass, he will make it level with the ground. And the promise of my Lord is ever true." So these are the 4 stories mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, and we have to derive lessons from it. So that's it. Hope this video helped you learn about Surah Al-Kahf.